Hi, hello students, welcome to Indian Tech Guru for you. So let us move on to the next topic. The next topic is bus and memory transfers. Bus and memory transfers. So in a digital system, we need to perform memory transfers between several devices. We need to perform memory transfers between hard disk drive or SSD to main memory and from main memory to hard disk drive or SSD. Similarly, we need to perform memory transfers between main memory to cache memory and from cache memory to main memory. Similarly, we need to perform memory transfers between cache memory to register memory and from register memory to cache memory. Like this, we need to perform memory transfers between multiple devices to multiple devices. To perform these memory transfers, we need a common gateway. We need a common path. That common path is nothing but the common bus. It is called as common bus. So generally, this common bus is laid on the motherboard. If you open the cabinet and see inside of the motherboard, then there will be parallel lines between several devices. So these are parallel lines which will be used to transmit the data is called as a common bus. So what is the purpose of a common bus? It is going to transfer the information between multiple components of the computer system. So, however, generally we say it is going to perform the transmission between registers in a multi-register configuration. So, inside of the computer, there will be several different registers. So, among the registers also, data must be transmitted. For performing those transmissions also, we need to use a common bus. However, to perform the transmission, we need to select a particular register as a source register and another register as destination register. Then only we can perform the transmission. So who is going to control these things? That is, who is going to decide what is the source register, what is the destination register, how to perform the data transmission? So all these things are controlled by the control signals. These control signals are going to determine which register is selected by the bus during each particular register transfer. So that is, what is the source register, what is the destination register, and when to perform the data transmission. So all these things are carried out so using the control signals. So actually, to implement this bus system, we may use two basic building blocks. So we may use multiplexers, and we may use three-state buffers. Either we may use the multiplexers to construct a bus structure, or we may use three-state buffers, or it can also be called as three-state bus buffers. Using these two building blocks, we are going to construct a bus structure. First, let us see the structure of a bus system using the multiplexers. So you already know what is the purpose of a multiplexer. It is going to take several inputs and give a single output. So there will be 2x1 multiplexers, 4x1 multiplexers, 8x1 multiplexers, 16x1 multiplexers. So you already studied in second year first semester about how these multiplexers are going to work. Now let us see how to construct a bus structure using these multiplexers. So for that purpose, let us design a multiplexer, let us design a bus system of four lines, a four line common bus, a four line common bus. So what it is going to do is, so it is going to select a particular register and send this register data through the four line common bus. So assume there are four registers available and each register is of a 4 bit size. So let us consider register A. Assume this is register A and each register is a 4 bit register, 0 1 2 3. So name it as register A, and it is going to transfer A0, A1, A2, A3. That is 0 bit of A, 1 bit of A, 2 bit of A, 3 bit of A. Similarly, consider register B. Register B will also contain 4 bits, 0, 1, 2, 3. So this one is a B0, B1, B2, B3. Similarly, next register, register C, 0, 1, 2, 3, C0, C1, C2, C3. And finally, register 4 is named as register D. It contains bits 0, 1, 2, 3, D0, D1, D2 and D3. Now, to transmit a particular register, we need n multiplexers. So here n represents the number of bits in a particular register. Here, how many bits are there in a particular register? 4 bits are there. So that is why we need 4 multiplexers. And these multiplexers also, we need to consider 4x1 multiplexers. That is, they are going to take 4 inputs and give 1 output. So now we need 4 multiplexers to transmit a single register. So assume this is a 4x1 multiplexer 0 and take another multiplexer 4x1 multiplexer 1 and another one 4x1 multiplexer 2, the last one 4x1 multiplexer 3. So we have considered 4 multiplexers. Now we are going to transmit a single register by transmitting each bit into each multiplexer. So for example, if I want to transmit register A, then A0 is transmitted to the 0 input of multiplexer 0. So that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 inputs for this multiplexer. Similarly, 0, 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 2, 3, and finally 0, 1, 2, 3. Now, if I want to transmit a register A, then I will be transmitting the 0 bit of A to the 0th location of multiplexer 0. Similarly, I am going to transmit A1 to the 0th location of multiplexer 1. Similarly, A2 to the 0 location of multiplexer 2. And finally, A3 to the 0 location of multiplexer 3. Okay. So, like this, we are going to transmit to the multiplexers. And the multiplexers are going to select a particular input and give it as a output. So, this is going to produce one line of output because it is a 4x1 multiplexer. And this multiplexer is going to produce one line output. And this multiplexer is going to produce one line of output. Finally, this one is going to produce one line of output. So, by this, we are going to get a 4-line common bus. A 4-line common bus. So, for example, assume that instead of register A, I need to transmit register D. Then how we are going to connect? So, I am going to connect the 0 bit of register D, to the third bit of multiplexer 0 and D1 to the third bit of multiplexer 1 and D2 to the third bit of multiplexer 2 and D3 to the third bit of multiplexer 3. Like this, we are going to connect, and the output will be D0, D1. D0 will be produced by multiplex 0, D1 will be produced by multiplexer 1, D2 will be produced by multiplexer 2, and D3 is going to be produced by multiplexer 3. So, finally, the register D will be transmitted through the bus. So, like this, a common bus structure occurs. So, now we can name these 0, 1, 2, 3 locations, as we already discussed, A0, B0, C0, D0, A1, B1, C1, D1, A2, B2, C2, D2, and A3, B3, C3, D3. However, we already discussed that there must be some control mechanism to make sure that which register must be selected. Now, there are 4 registers: register A, register B, register C, register D. But which register need to be selected should be controlled by a control mechanism. This control mechanism is actually carried by 2 selection lines. So, these selection lines are called as S1, S0. So, S1 is one selection line and S0 is another selection line. These selection lines are connected to each multiplexer, which is going to control which register must be selected. So, these selection lines will be connected to each and every multiplexer. Like this. S1 and S0. Now, based on the selection lines input, it is going to decide which register should be selected. So, if you consider S1, S0, S1, S0. So initially the values may be 00, 01, 10, 11. The possible combinations. The possible combinations for two bits is 00, 01, 10, 11. So whenever the values are like this, then the register selected, will be, so whenever S1 is 0 and S2 S0 is 0, register A will be selected. And then for 01, register B will be selected, 10, register C, 11, register D. So that is why these are called as the selection lines. Selection lines are going to determine which register will be selected to be passed through the 4-line common bus. Okay, like this, we are going to construct a bus structure using multiplexers. So what are the things we need to remember here? If there are 4 bits in the register, then we need to consider 4 multiplexers. We need to consider 4 multiplexers. Okay, that is very, very important. As we are considering four registers, we need to select a particular register, we need to use a 4x1 multiplexer. We need to use 4x1 multiplexers. For example, assume that we are using 8 registers, then we need to use 8x1 multiplexers. So because those many number of data lines we need. Okay, those many number of data lines we need. So to have more clarity, let us take one more example and see how to construct another bus so that you will get more clarity. Let us construct a 16-bit common bus. 16-bit common bus with 8 registers. We need to consider 8 registers, and each register is going to contain 16 bits. So let us construct a 16-bit common bus so that you will get more clarity. So total how many registers? 8 registers are there. So name them in alphabetical order. This one is register A. And how many bits? 16 bits in each register. 0, 1, 2 and so on up to 15. Similarly, register B. How many bits? 0, 1, 2 and so on, 15 and so on. Register C, D, E, F, G, H. So 8th register is register H. So 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on up to 15. So this is register H. So assume that as we cannot accommodate the remaining registers, so this is register A, register B and so on up to register H. So total how many registers? 8 registers are there. Each register is having 16 bits. Now how to decide the number of multiplexers we need? So number of multiplexers will be based on the number of bits in a register. So how many bits are there in a register? 16 bits are there. So that is why how many multiplexers we need? 16 multiplexers we need. Okay. So let us take 16 multiplexers. And 16 multiplexers of what type? How many data lines are there? We need a total 8 data lines. How many data lines? 8 data lines. So what are they? For example, if you consider register A, so A0, B0, C0, D0, E0, as well as H0. Okay. From A to H, how many data lines we need? We need 8 data lines. So that is why what type of multiplexers we need to consider? We need to consider 8 by 1 multiplexers. So 8 by 1 multiplexer 0. Okay. Similarly, one more. 8 by 1 multiplexer 1. And 8 by 1 multiplexer 2. And so on up to 8 by 1 multiplexer 15. So total how many multiplexers? 16 multiplexers we need. Okay. What type of multiplexers? 8 by 1 multiplexers. 8 by 1 multiplexers means how many inputs? 8 inputs. There should be 8 inputs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 0. That is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Total 8 inputs must be there and 1 output must be there. So what should be these inputs? A0, B0, C0, D0, E0, F0, G0 and H0. For this multiplexer, A1, B1, C1 and so on, H1. For the last one, A15, B15 and so on up to H15. Okay. So like this, we are going to apply the data lines. So now the multiplexer 0 is going to generate one output line. The multiplexer 1 is going to generate the second output line. Multiplexer 2 is going to generate the third output line. And like this, output lines will be generated. And finally, multiplexer 15 is going to generate the 16th output line. So like this, total output lines will be 16. So like this, we are going to generate a 16-bit common bus. 16-bit common bus. Okay. So however, which register must be selected is determined by selection lines. As we have seen previously, to select a 4-bit register, what we did, we have used two selection lines, S1 and S0. S1 and S0. Okay. So these connections you might be familiar. So this 0 bit will be connected to this A0. 1 bit will be connected to A1. 2 bit will be connected to this A2. And final 15th bit will be connected to this A15. Okay, remaining you can easily understand. So how many selection lines must be there? There must be three selection lines. Three selection lines, S2, S1, S0. S2, S1 and S0. So these selection lines must be connected to each multiplexer like this we are going to connect the selection lines. So why these selection, what is the necessity of these selection lines? So based on the selection lines input only, we are going to select a particular register. So what will be the selection lines inputs? S2, S1, S0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1. So which register will be selected based on this input? Register selected. Register selected. So if the input is, if the selection lines input is 0, 0, 0, register A will be selected. 001 B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Like this, registers will be selected. So, like this, we can enhance and construct any bit common bus. So, like this only, we can construct 32 bit common bus, 64 bit common bus using the same procedure. Using the multiplexers. Okay, so hope you understand how to extend the required common bus based on the terminology. What are the key points here? The key points are, we need how many number of multiplexers? It is decided based on the number of bits in a register. If it is a 16 bit register, we need 16 multiplexers. If it is a 4 bit register, we need 4 multiplexers. So what should be the type of the multiplexer? That will be decided based on the input lines. Based on the input lines. Based on the input lines means how many registers are there. Here how many registers are there? 8 registers are there. So because 8 registers are there, how many data input lines we need? 8 input lines we need. How many output lines? Always 1 output line. So what type of multiplexers we need? We need 8 by 1 multiplexers. 8 by 1 multiplexers. Similarly, how to select the number of selection lines? How many number of selection lines are needed? So, because here we are using 8 registers, we need 3 selection lines because 2 cube is equal to 8. So, if you use 16 registers, then we need 4 selection lines. 4 selection lines. Like that, based on the number of registers we are going to use, the number of selection lines needed will be increased. So this is how we are going to implement a 16 bit common bus for 8 registers of 16 bit size. Now let us move on to the second type of implementation, second basic building block we are going to use to construct a common bus. The second building block that is used to construct a common bus is a three-state bus buffer. Three-state bus buffer. Okay, so what is meant by buffer? A buffer is nothing but a storage location. A storage location, it is going to hold some content, a bit of content. Okay, so previously we have seen how to construct a common bus using multiplexers. Now instead of multiplexers, we can consider a three state bus buffer also to construct a common bus. So what is meant by three state bus buffer? So how it looks like? What will be the input and what will be the output? Now let us consider the graphic symbols for three state bus buffer. So a three state buffer looks like this. So there will be input A. This is normal input, This is called as normal input, and there will be a control input, a control input C. This is called as control input. This one is normal input, this one is control input. So the output will be based on the control input. In a three state buffer, the output will be based on the control input. If control input is equal to 1, then the output Y is equal to A. So for example, if C is equal to 1 and A is equal to 0, then the output will be 0. If C is equal to 1 and A is equal to 1, then output will be 1. That is, whatever the value of A, whatever the value of input, that will be passed as it is as output, okay, without any change. And if C is equal to 0, if the control input is 0, then it is going to produce high impedance. It is going to produce high impedance. High impedance means high resistance. So that is, there will not be any output at all. There will not be any output at all. So it will not be either 0 or 1. No output will be produced. Okay. So remember, very simple thing. What is that? If C is equal to 1, output is equal to same as input. If C is equal to 0, high impedance. High impedance means no output at all. Okay. So like this, the three state buffer works. The three state buffer works. So here high impedance means, so nothing is actually transmitted. Now let us see a bus line with three state buffers. Bus line with three state buffers. So actually, to produce a bus line for a single bit, we need 4 three state buffers. So assume that A0 is the 0 bit of register 1 and B0 is the 0 bit of register 2 and C0 is the 0 bit of register 3 and D0 is the 0 bit of register 4. So these registers are connected to three state buffers. C0, D0. And now we need to provide the control signal, control line. Thus, that control line is actually selected based on the selection lines, based on the selection lines. Okay. So S1, S0. These are the selection lines. Okay. Select. And here we are going to give 2 inputs. But we need to provide outputs for control signals for 4 three state buffers. Okay. So using 2 inputs, we need to produce 4 output signals. So that is why we are going to use 2x4 decoder. 2x4 decoder. So using 2x4 decoder means, so S1, S0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. So 0, 0, 0, 0 is going to produce 0, 0, 1 is going to produce 1, 2, 3. 0, 1, 2, 3. So what does it mean? If it is 0, 0, if it is 0, 0, then here the control signal will be set to 1. Whenever this control signal is set to 1, then A0 bit will be transmitted. All the remaining bits control signals will be set to 0. Then remaining 3 will be in high impedance. Okay. So you need to understand that. So whenever S1 and S2 are both zeros, then we are going to enable the 0 bit. Whenever we enable the 0 bit, then the signal will be sent to A0, the positive signal. That is why whatever the A0 bit value, let it be 0 or 1, that will be sent as a output. Okay. Output through this bus line. So the output for these particular lines will also be connected to the same line. Like this. And now, because we made C is equal to 1, whatever the input of A0, that will be transmitted as output. Similarly, if it is 0, 1, then we make this second line C is equal to 1 and all the remaining 0, then B0 bit will be transmitted through the bus. And remaining control input is 0, so it is going to produce high impedance. That is why no output will be generated. So what does it mean? We are going to select either A0 or B0 or C0 or D0. So this particular diagram is a representation for only one bit selection. Okay. So like this, if you are having 4 bits in a register, then we need 4 of these particular devices to select 4 bits. Okay. So this diagram is going to select only 1 bit, either A0 or B0 or C0 or D0. Similar diagram like this is going to select either A1 or B1 or C1 or D1. Like this, if you mix 4 of these diagrams, then we are going to get a four line bus, which we have seen previously using multiplexers. Okay. To get such a diagram, 4 diagrams like this should be combined so that we are going to get output. So for example, if you need a register A, then what are the bits we need? We need A0, A1, A2, A3. So this particular diagram is going to generate single bit. What is that? A0. Another diagram, A1, another diagram, A2, another diagram, A3. If you combine all of these 3, then we are going to get the register A. Like this, this diagram is going to represent one bit selection. Okay. So don't be confused. So here it is going to perform the activity like a multiplexer only. However, instead of using a multiplexer, we are going to use a three state buffer. Okay. So generally, in case of the normal gates, so how many inputs will be there? So there will be two inputs. So however, here there is only one input, and another input is a control input. Based on the control input, we are going to decide whether the given input will be propagated as output or to produce high impedance means nothing is transmitted. So as here we can observe, there are 4 outputs basically. So either you can transmit A0, B0, C0, D0 based on the control input. If the control input is 0, if the control input is 1, then we are going to transmit. If the control input is 0, then we are going to produce high impedance. High impedance means nothing is transmitted. So among A0, B0, C0, D0, so only either A0 or B0 or C0 or D0 will be transmitted. Same thing like a 4x1 multiplexer. So it is going to perform the same logic as the multiplexer. However, we are going to use another building block known as the 3-state bus buffer. Okay. So like this, we are going to implement a common bus. We are going to implement a common bus. So now we have seen how to implement a common bus using multiplexers as well as using the 3-state bus buffer. So once we successfully establish a bus structure, then for what we are going to establish this bus, common bus, to perform the data transmissions, So in general, from where we are going to access the content, we are going to access the content in between the registers. We are going to transmit the content in between the registers. Okay, in between the registers. So we are going to move the content from one register to another register. So basically, there will be two operations for performing these transactions. The first operation is read operation. The second operation is write operation. Okay. So what is meant by read operation? We are going to fetch some data from a particular location and store in a particular register. Okay. So that is represented as DR assignment M of AR. Okay. Here DR represents data register. AR represents address register. Sometimes instead of using DR and AR, we may use MDR and MAR. MDR represents memory data register. MAR represents memory address register. Okay. So this is how a read operation is done. How we are going to perform the write operation? We are going to move the content of DR to a particular memory location. M of AR is assigned to DR. Okay. So these are the two basic operations we are going to perform while data transmissions. So DR assignment M of AR means fetch a particular location from the main memory and move the content to the register named as DR. Okay. So assume this is main memory. And in this main memory, several memory locations will be there. And here some data is stored. For example, number 40 is stored. Okay. And address location is 0xFA2. Okay, 0x means hexadecimal. Now, if I want to fetch this value and store inside of the register DR, then what I am going to do? I am going to do an operation such as DR assignment M of 0xFA2. Then what it is going, this operation is going to do, it is going to read the content 40 and store the content in register DR. Similarly, this is read operation. Similarly, example for write operation, M of 0x FC9 assignment TR. Okay, so assume that DR is consisting of the same 40 value. Now I want to move this 40 value to M of 0x FC9 and assume that 0x FC9 address is somewhere here, then what it is going to do? It is going to write the content of DR into this location. So now 40 will be written here. So however, don't think that always DR contains the fetched value. Okay. So sometimes DR value may be updated. DR value may be updated. So inside of the register or some other register value may be stored in DR. So like this, it may contain this value or some other value, because it is just a like a variable. The value may change. Okay. So like this, we are going to perform the read as well as write operations. Whenever we are going to perform these read and write operations, the memory bus, the common bus, will help to transmit the data from one location to another location. So hope you understand the logic. We'll continue the remaining topics in the next session. That's all for now.